Hello everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. In this video, we'll cover high availability for DrayTek routers. High availability, also called hardware redundancy, refers to the capability of automatically switching hardware, such as a standby router, when a primary router fails due to various reasons, such as a loss of power or hardware failure. High availability is crucial in scenarios where any network outage can result in significant loss or service disruption. Organisations such as company headquarters, hospitals, utility companies, and data centres need their networks to always be available and not be affected by disruptions. High availability in DrayTek routers works by utilising the Common Address Redundancy Protocol, known as CARP, which allows multiple hosts on the same local area network to share a virtual IP address. That common virtual IP address is shared among all the routers in the high availability group and serves as the default gateway for all clients in the network. Most dual-WAN and multi-WAN DrayTek routers support high availability. That includes the Vigor 2865 series, the Vigor 2866 series, the Vigor 2927 series, the Vigor 2962 series, and the Vigor 3910 and Vigor 3912. There are some differences between older and newer models to be aware of. Some older models, like the Vigor 2925 series, require identical routers for high availability. High availability wasn't supported between two different models, even if they were from the same series. However, in newer models, the routers still need to be from the same series, but can differ in version. For example, a Vigor 2927 can be paired with a Vigor 2927 AC. DrayTek routers offer two redundancy modes. The first is hot standby mode. Here, both the primary and secondary routers share the same WAN source. During normal operations, only the primary router is active. If the primary router goes down, the secondary router takes over, using the same WAN connection, ensuring uninterrupted internet access. The second is active standby mode. Here, the primary and secondary routers use different WAN sources. Both routers are online simultaneously, each with its own WAN connection. One WAN connection acts as the standby in this mode. Okay, let's check out hot standby mode in action. In this demonstration, we've configured two Vigor 2927 series routers in hot standby mode, connected to a Vigor P1282 switch. Here we have one primary router and one secondary router. Both routers have their WAN ports connected to the same modem, while two of their LAN ports are connected to the P1282 switch. An additional cable connects the switch to a PC. When we log into the virtual IP address, the router interface displays the 2927A, which is the primary router. Down here under Diagnostics High Availability, we can see the routers in the High Availability group and their current status. We'll check internet connectivity by pinging Google DNS, that's 8.8.8.8, and monitoring the response time using Ping Plotter. Now, to simulate a failure, we'll power off the primary router. The secondary router monitors the primary and detects the failure. Once it confirms the primary router is down, it takes over the routing functions. Okay, so pings are timing out as expected. The failover process takes approximately 3 seconds, resulting in 2 to 3 dropped packets. And there it goes off again. The ping response resumes, so we know the secondary router has kicked in. So now when we log into the virtual IP address again, the router interface now displays the 2927B, which is the secondary router. And we can see that down in Diagnostics High Availability. The 2927B router has become the primary. Okay, let's see what happens when the 2927A router comes back online. So we power the primary router back on. This normally only takes a second. Thinking, and bang, it's back online. Just a longer response for that one ping, but no timeout. Now when we log in using the virtual IP address, the 2927A is the primary router again, and we can confirm that in the high availability status menu. Thank you for watching. Please like or leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02 98 38 8899.